Hey guys, TikTok Sully here, or just Sully, back with another video. And today I wanted to bring you a video on the brand Fear of God. This brand has had a great few years in the industry, and I don't think it's going to be slowing down anytime soon. With the clothes that are always in high demand, to the designs that are constantly being replicated, Fear of God has had a great few years in the industry, and that's basically been its whole lifespan, seeing as it's only been around since 2013. So let's take a look at how the brand was able to become one of the most highly sought after brands in streetwear, and how the owner Jerry Lorenzo was able to create such a celebrated brand, as well as take a look at Mr. Jerry Lorenzo's life leading up to Fear of God. So let's get into it, and hope you guys enjoy. Kicking it off, Jerry Lorenzo was born in 1976 in Sacramento, California. His family moved around quite a bit, so they didn't stay put in California and eventually moved to Chicago. Jerry's father, also named Jerry Manuel, had a position as a baseball minor league coach out in Chicago, which led to this move for the Manuel family. His father had also previously been a professional MLB player, moved into minor league coaching and coordinating, which then led to managerial positions at top MLB teams such as the Chicago White Sox and the New York Mets. So baseball was a big part of Jerry Manuel Sr.'s life, in turn making it a big part of Jerry Lorenzo's life growing up, which would have an influence on him later on. Another theme that was central to Jerry Lorenzo's childhood was his Christian faith. Both his mother and father were practicing Christians, and they would sometimes read religious literature together, such as devotionals, which are books that concentrate on Bible verses whilst explaining them to the reader and allowing them to ponder on the verses. Through this, Jerry was exposed to a family favorite devotional titled My Utmost for His Highest by Oswald Chambers. We'll get back to this book later on in this video, but Jerry continued to follow the natural process of school, and he attended a predominantly white high school where he was exposed to some of his grunge influences such as Metallica, and he also attended his local black church where he was exposed to the contrasting hip-hop scene. So this is an example of a time when this juxtaposition of influences was introduced to Jerry, and this is important to mention because it's what we see realized into his brand Fear of God today. Around this time, he had also begun to find interest in vintage t-shirts, which he later began collecting, eventually garnering a considerable collection. A collection so large, he even ended selling some off in the form of Fear of God merchandise. After he graduated high school, he graduated college, then decided to go to Loyola Marymount in Los Angeles to study business. Whilst he was here, he worked retail, as many students tend to do, varying from work at The Gap to a stock boy at Diesel. So he had pretty obvious interest in clothing, even though he was headed in a different direction. After graduating Loyola with an MBA, Jerry continued to follow his journey in sports, specifically baseball as previously explained, and with a little help from his father's relationships, he was able to land a job at a sports agency back in Chicago. This job introduced Jerry to celebrities and sports stars, and he did this for a little while before deciding to move back to LA, where he continued his role as a sports agent, but also began hosting club nights under the title of JL Nights, after he failed to find hip-hop orientated nights that attracted him and others like him in the city of LA. So he took advantage of this gap in the market. JL Nights, which he ran with his partner Javier Laval, ran 4 to 5 times a week, and this played a big role in introducing Jerry to more of the celebrity circle, after these club nights began to attract all the right people from the hip-hop crowd, ranging from Kid Cudi and Big Sean to Tyga and Chris Brown, even Kanye West and his crew, which included the likes of Don C, Ivan Jasper and Virgil Abloh. Jerry also met Dodgers player Matt Kemp whilst out in LA, who he began representing through his career as a sports agent, as well as doubling as a stylist for him. JL Nights was a popping night out in LA, and this ran for some time, allowing Jerry to form genuine relationships with these celebrities that he would eventually create clothes for. In 2009, Jerry had a cameo in Keri Hilson's Knock You Down video after helping a little on set, showing he was further penetrating into this crowd of hip-hop musicians, and again in 2012 for Tyga Still Got It video. But before Tyga Still Got It video could release, Jerry had found himself in a relationship with his soon-to-be wife, Desiree Manuel, and And after enjoying his ventures with GM Knights and working for Mark Kemp whilst in LA, he continued to style for Mark Kemp, which brings us to 2011 and the beginning of the inception of Fear of God. Around this time, Jerry was looking for clothes to put Mark Kemp in, when he found himself dumbfounded with what was available. Not only was the stuff on the market saturated, but there was also a void of clothing that had yet to be conceived. And not only did Jerry want this for Mark Kemp, he also wanted these unavailable pieces for himself, which got him to thinking, if these pieces were missing from his wardrobe, then surely they must be missing from other males' wardrobes too. This led Jerry to begin designing in hopes to create a few pieces. One of the earlier notorious pieces that was unique to Jerry Lorenzo was the short sleeve hoodie with the Riri side zips. Not only creating something casual, but creating a new luxury casual garment, which was the niche he found missing from the market. Not long after, Jerry had found himself designing multiple pieces, whilst also visiting local LA factories, learning as he went along, and also using the money from JL Knights to help fund this new venture. Before the year was over, Jerry had found himself with enough pieces to create a small collection. This is when we return back to his childhood. Jerry was one day visiting his parents in California, and upon enjoying meditation with them in the California sun, they found themselves in conversation on the previously mentioned family favorite devotional, My Utmost for His Highest by Oswald Chambers. In this book, Chambers talks about the fear of God humans should have, whether that be out of respect through knowing God or through uncertainty through being distant from God. And this really resonated with Jerry in the juxtaposition this statement was making, as well as how the Bible and religion was being presented in a new and cool manner. This would inspire Jerry's brand in its brand name, as well as attempt to remove the preconceived notions of Christianity or just being religious in general as a colorless and boring concept. This was the message Jerry envisioned, and the clothes were to be perfectly crafted closet essentials for men, which when combined produced the brand that is Fear of God. And this brings us to 2012, where the Fear generation would begin, kicking off with Big Sean. Jerry's soon-to-be wife Desiree, who was friends with Big Sean's stylist, introduced the two, and Jerry showed his Fear of God garments to her, in which she thought Big Sean would really like them. And she was right. It started with the longer length t-shirts by Fear of God, to later the short sleeve hoodie, in which Big Sean was happy to wear because it was casual luxury, something Jerry knew people were looking for to help keep them stylish and comfortable. Not to mention, this was the Renaissance era in fashion, so it was the perfect time to inject Fear of God into the scene. This then led to Kanye West seeing these pieces on Big Sean, which would prompt him to get in contact with Jerry, in which Jerry provided Kanye with some Fear of God merchandise as well as showed him the rest of his collection. Kanye was so impressed, he hired Jerry to help work on his latest fashion venture, which was the Kanye West and APC collaboration at the time. Jerry Lorenzo was also later recruited by Kanye to help work on his Yeezus tour merch and even on his brand Yeezy. But after 2012, after Kanye and Big Sean had fell in love with Fear of God, a domino effect began in which other musicians and celebrities became interested in the Fear of God label. Hype began to circulate this new LA brand, which nobody even really knew too much about, seeing as Fear of God had yet to even make their pieces available to purchase. And in 2013, Jerry would go ahead and finally preview his first collection. And by spring 2013, his first collection for Fear of God would finally arrive, featuring pieces we saw Big Sean and Kanye West in, as well as other memorable pieces, including a grey side zip hoodie and a leather kilt. Around this time, Jerry's soon-to-be wife Desiree also gave birth to twin girls, making Jerry a father of three, having two girls and one older son being Jerry Lorenzo Manuel III. By 2014, Jerry had released his second collection for Fear of God, this time with a refinement on the first collection, still highlighting those original pieces whilst also adding a few additional pieces. And by 2015, the third collection was ready to be released. By now, Fear of God's resurrected vintage t-shirts had become a thing, and the third collection would feature a pair of sweatpants that Fear of God consumers found to be an essential they never knew they needed. By the fourth collection, Fear of God had become one of the hottest brands of this new era, and Jerry would continue to dominate the fashion scene by releasing a pair of iconic ripped denim that would highlight his fourth collection and also sell out on a recurring basis. Mixing and matching the collections was a great way to style an outfit, as they all seemed to be cohesive upon each release, sticking to the vision Jerry initially had for the brand. Near the end of 2015, Jerry would also get into footwear design and introduce some new silhouettes to the Fear of God brand, being a high military boot, which soon followed with a mid-basketball sneaker. Around this time, Jerry and Desiree would finally get married, and Jerry would continue with his Fear of God ventures by branching out and collaborating with Pacsun to bring a new diffusion line to the brand, being Fog, which would appeal to a younger demographic and allow them to access the brand with its lower price point. In 2016, Jerry would collaborate with his brother in faith, musician Justin Bieber, to bring a capsule collection to his personal Purpose tour following the release of the album. This was a huge milestone for Jerry as it allowed him to work with one of the biggest artists outside of hip hop and open him up to a new world of consumers, as well as allow him to bring his message of conviction to a larger crowd. This collaboration had Jerry Lorenzo written all over it, and you could see the influence in his designs as they mimic Fear of God's inspiration of grunge. By 2017, Fear of God had the fifth collection ready whilst working on their own time and calendar. This time, the looks were more sports orientated, with influences from baseball, basketball, and even motocross. And much like the past four collections, the fifth collection was also heavily worn by celebrities including the likes of Migos, Justin Bieber and Jay-Z. Jerry continues to push the Fear of God brand forward as he collaborated multiple times with brands such as Vans, Chapel NYC and Ready Made, and even designed some more tour apparel and merchandise following the Justin Bieber stint for acts such as Kendrick Lamar, Janet Jackson and Jay-Z. By 2018, Jerry had shut down his diffusion line Fog and rebranded it to a new line entitled Essentials in an attempt to completely detach the two and focus on separate directions for each brand, being the mainline and the diffusion. Jerry has done all this whilst remaining independent and designing all on his own, something he hopes to get help with in the future by partnering with a group to help take Fear of God to that next level. So everything that's been talked about in this video is really only the beginning of Fear of God, and I'm sure there's more to see from Jerry Lorenzo and his Fear of God, which brings me to the end of this video. Fear of God has been popular since its inception, and I think that's down to the fact that Jerry really has been able to create well-crafted pieces as well as be ahead of the trend 95% of the time. On some instances, he's even started the trend, so I felt it was an important brand to cover, and as well as that, I am a fan of the brand as well as Jerry Lorenzo, so it was something I wanted to talk about. Hope you guys enjoyed and learned a few things. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button, it always helps and is much appreciated. And if you're new here and you're interested in fashion, then you should also subscribe by clicking over here, as I do have some more videos like this on the way, and it'll just allow you to stay up to date with the uploads. I'll also leave some social handles in the description if you want to keep up to date with me, so check that out down below. But yeah, that's all from this video. Hope I covered everything essential to the Fear of God brand, and as I said, you learned a few things. But that's all from me today. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.